Drama started when Nicholas Chiza smuggled into the council a petition written by a whistleblower identified as Robert Herrera seeking for the removal of two district land board members, namely Peterson Eugene Chomhendo and Muzamiru Barihamwe, for forging academic documents.
Members were erroneously recommended by the district council and submitted for approval in a letter dated on 15 March 2022.
Nicholas's submission sparked procedural matters from councillors asking why they should debate a matter that is not on the order paper. However, the speaker overruled them and asked them to sit down, which sparked a heated verbal exchange between the councillor Vincent Opio and the speaker. As a result, the speaker adjourned the council sitting until further notice.
Nobody was going to fight him. We requested him to follow the procedure as stipulated in the standard rules of procedure and conduct council the way it is supposed to be.
Using the issue of procedure and blocking people to participate, people have right to participate, people have right to contribute. So speaker was blocking people from participating.
The councillors accused the speaker of causing a financial loss to the district. They asked the speaker to change his ways and act professionally.
Whatever was to be discussed today must be pushed in the May Council, which is really a disservice to our own people, which is a financial loss we have caused. He has caused a financial loss because Council has sat and there is no fruits from it.
We are so annoyed. We voted young people who came here for employment and making money. Councillors are supposed to debate issues.
You can't work as student of the standard rules of procedure. By the way, it's kind of conducting council is not the best way, as if he not even go to school.
He should stop being a dictator. We ask him to style up. The district speaker, Christopher Nkalu, explained why he adjourned the sitting prematurely.
We have adjourned this council prematurely after citing violence.
Just like the leader of government's business said, it's become a habit. A habitual habit that is uncalled for, and the district I'm leading, we are not accepting this kind of, hula-baloo kind of talk and, coming in to distract a young district like Chikube.
The next council sitting is expected to convene in April to lay the budget. Story compiled by Ambrose Niwagabakatoto for the news.